वेलकम यू टू रेडियो खांची 90.4 FM, हम सबका रेडियो। आई एम सोमाली फौजदार। आई वर्क एज अ गेस्ट लेक्चरर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ योगा एट रांची यूनिवर्सिटी। आई विल बी टॉकिंग ऑन समाधि, कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ समाधि एंड अबाउट सविकल्प एंड निर्विकल्प समाधि। दिस टॉपिक विल बी हेल्पफुल फॉर स्टूडेंट्स अंडर गोइंग PG एज वेल एज डिप्लोमा कोर्सेज इन योगा। नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट first by discussing what is samadhi. Samadhi is the result of total one-pointedness of mind and expansion of consciousness from ordinary consciousness to cosmic awareness. In samadhi, you will be conscious of all things as you are now. Samadhi is the state of highest sense, intelligence and vigilance. You maintain the normal sense of discrimination, but your entire physical, mental, intellectual and social crisis will be over. You do not become inactive in samadhi. Rather, you can work hard tirelessly for days together. You remain equal-minded in all circumstances, birth, death, sorrow, joy, loss, gain, insult or praise. Just like deep sleep, you are filled with absolute serenity and bliss. The only difference is, in deep sleep, you are unconscious, but in samadhi, you are balanced, peaceful and serene. Samadhi is an effortless state where the mind is fully active in the world and totally absorbed in what one is doing. In samadhi, there is neither physical nor mental consciousness. There is only spiritual consciousness. There is only existence. That is your real swaroop. The state of samadhi is a higher state of the unconscious. When the individual self passes through the phases of the unconscious and is about to enter into superconscious, that is the state when samadhi dawns. Therefore, samadhi arises in the final phase of unconscious and unfolds in the superconscious. When one has the experience of superconsciousness, then one is able to know that experience, but unable to recall what kind of experience it was and what kind of feeling it was. In the Upanishads and in many other books, it is said that the experience of samadhi is beyond all explanations. For this reason, it is very difficult for great men to say anything about samadhi because they do not know how to express it and they also do not know what to express. The explanation of samadhi cannot be communicated by speech or physical signs, but the conscious mind remembers that it had some sort of experience. Samadhi is a state where the awareness does not go through the conscious, subconscious or the unconscious. It does not go through the physical, astral or the causal dimensions. A complete transformation in the personality takes place. One is unable to say about the experience, but the effects of samadhi are there. It is something like a sleeping man who is given a hypnotic pill without knowing him. He has certain experiences, and when he comes back to normal consciousness, he does not know what experience he had. He has a hangover, but he does not remember that he was given a pill. In the same way, in samadhi, one does not experience it through the physical medium, neither through sense or mind. Samadhi is realization and awareness that grace is flowing through you and you are part of that reality. At this point, you are freed from the attractions and repulsions of life. You are freed from rag and dvesh. You become free from the attachments and dependencies. You realize that you are not restrained by the body or mind, but have unlimited ability and power, which can be used to uplift yourself or others. The mind becomes very powerful through the practice of pratyahar, dharana, dhyan and samadhi. One gets the access to all hidden potentials and one can fully experience them. There is expansion and expression of soft qualities like love, compassion, patience, and where one acts for the welfare of all. Samadhi is a state where there is complete absorption of mind. The experience of dhyan can be felt for 10 seconds, 30 seconds, a minute or half an hour. But when this span increases and one lives with that experience for days together, it is the state of samadhi. If you can fix your mind for 10 seconds steadily on a particular object, it is dharana, concentration. 10 such dharanas become dhyan, and 10 such dhyans form samadhi. The mind loses its own consciousness and becomes identified with the object of meditation. In the trained yogis or siddhas, you cannot say where pratyahara ends and dharana begins, where dharana ends and dhyan begins, where dhyan ends and samadhi begins. The moment they sit on asana, all the processes occurs simultaneously with electric or lightning speed and they enter samadhi at their conscious will. In Yoga Sutra Chapter 3, Vibhuti Pad, Sutra 3, it says, Tadeva artha matra nirbhasam swarupa shunyam eva samadhi. That state becomes samadhi when there is only object appearing without the consciousness of one's own self. In dharana, the consciousness is broken, in dhyan it is continuous, and in samadhi it becomes one with the object of concentration. It may be a gross object or a subtle object. In samadhi, there is no consciousness that one is practicing concentration. Thus, if you are practicing concentration on the symbol Om, it will shine with complete awareness. As you go deeper into the stages of samadhi, the object becomes more clear and vivid. You do not remain aware of your own existence. There is not even the awareness that you are practicing concentration. This is the first stage of samadhi. You remember the object, but there is no other awareness of the witness remaining. Actually, the mind or the consciousness is there, but appears to be non-existent because you are not aware of yourself or of the process of concentration. When meditation is continued on any object, and when the object becomes very clear, there is no personal awareness for the time being. The object and you become one. This is the state of samyam. The state of samyam is totality of the processes of dharana, dhyana and samadhi. In the beginning, you are aware of the subjective and objective awareness. You are aware of the object of meditation within as well as outside. But gradually, the outside awareness drops and you only see the thing that is inside. That is dhyan. When the things become clearer inside and simultaneously you lose your personal awareness, that is called samadhi. The power of mind is awakened. It does not depend on the senses, rather it becomes a medium to take you closer to experience the self. When the consciousness goes beyond the physical and the pranic sense of awareness, but remains in the mental awareness of manomay kosh, that is the beginning of samadhi. Later, when the awareness crosses the sphere of all the koshas, then samadhi is achieved. Here it transcends all the object, motion, thought and instincts. Now let us discuss the characteristics of samadhi. There are two characteristics of samadhi. One, the object only shines, and two, there is no awareness of the process of the self. As the student goes on making progress on the path of concentration, there is concentration in the beginning, but it is broken time and again. Thus, concentration continues for some time and suddenly there is a break. This is the first stage. The second stage, there is more of dhyan and less of breaks. And in the third stage, you start with dharana and immediately go into dhyan and suddenly there comes a void. The meditator has dissolved his personality till he becomes simply the instrument of God. When his mouth opens, it speaks God's words without effort or forethought through direct intuition, and when he raises his hand, God flows again through that to work a miracle. Now let's discuss on classification of samadhi. Samadhi is classified under two categories: savikalp samadhi with seed and nirvikalp samadhi, that is without seed. Your seed means samskar, which manifests in the form of vikalpa. In savikalp samadhi, The mind is fixed on some gross or subtle symbol. The symbol is in the form of pratyaya in the mind. Pratyaya depends on three gunas. Initially, sadhak begins with minimum pratyaya or minimum objects on which he fixes his mind. Later, the mind gradually becomes free from pratyayas. According to sage Patanjali, savikalp samadhi has four types of vikalp. They are vitarka, vichar, anand and asmita. Here the consciousness operates within the sphere of koshas. Nirvikalp or nirbhid samadhi is beyond individual awareness and consciousness. It is without vibration and movement. There is complete stillness. It is that state where the last trance of samskaras and vikalpas are eliminated. Nirbhid samadhi is again of two types, nirbija and dharmamegha samadhi. From the dharmamegha samadhi onwards, there is complete freedom from karmas and kleshas. So I end up here today. Thank you.